nothing like summer in the city. Someone under stress, someone looking pretty. There's trouble in the air, you can smell it. And Alexander's by himself, I'll let him tell it. I haven't slept in a week. I was weak, I was awake. You've never seen a bastard orphan more in need of a break. Longing for Angelica, missing my wife. That's when Miss Mariah Reynolds walked into my life. She said,
I know you are a man of honor. I'm so sorry to bother you at home, but I don't know where to go, and I can't leave all alone.
She said,
my husband's doing me wrong, beating me, cheating me, mistreating me. Suddenly he's up and gone. I
So I offered her a loan, I offered to walk her home. She said,
you're too kind, sir.
I gave her 30 bucks and I had socked away. She lived a block away. She said,
fine, sir.
Then I said, well, I should head back home. She turned red, she led me to her bed, let her legs spread and said, hey,
hey.
That's when I began to pray, Lord, show me how to say no to this. I don't know how to say no to this. But my God, she looks so helpless, and her body's saying hell yes.
No,
show me how to say no to this. I don't know how to say no to this. In my mind I'm trying to go, help no. Then her mouth is on mine and I don't say
no.
Was the last time I said that last time it became a pastime. A month into this endeavor, I received a letter from a Mr. James Reynolds. Even better, it said,
dear sir, I hope this letter finds you in good health and in a prosperous enough position to put wealth in the pockets of people like me down on their luck. You see, that was my wife who you decided to seeing my whole wife if the price is right. If not, I'm telling your wife.
So I run up to her face, to her face, screamed, I'll put you in her face.
No, sir.
After the rest apologetic, I'm